duckie world.
Yeah, make way for the SOV.
Fading off into the distance, that was Random by Lady Sovereign. This is the dnD Power Hour, coming to you live and in full effect from Toronto, Canada, blasting out to HabboHotel.com and HabboHotel.ca and across the internet airwaves through Live 365. Dubya, my friend, how are you, sir?
Very, very well. Sort of a bit chillier than I was last week. But,
of course.
Chillier, yes.
Yeah, well, I had to come back from Santa Monica a bit earlier than you did, my friend. And let's just say, Habbos, remember the conversion rate. When you're in the United States coming back to Canada, you have to remember how to convert metric. And that is both with Fahrenheit and Celsius. But we won't get into that right now. Let's just say last week when we were in Los Angeles, it was nice and warm. Now we're back in Toronto, it is cold. But we don't need to talk about cold tonight, because the show itself is going to be warm, hot, and on fire. We are transcending through the internet airwaves, through the telecommunication wonder that is Alexander Graham Bell's invention. On the other side of the Atlantic, the other side of the pond, in sweet old Britannia, we have live and in full effect Lady Sovereign in Habbo Hotel. Sov, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Hello and welcome to North America in the virtual way that we can with Habbo Hotel.
Woo! Hello.
What's the weather like over in the UK?
I'm guessing it's kind of like Canada right now. It's freezing.
Well, hang on. We saw a show on the BBC that showed freezing as -2 degrees Celsius, whereas for us, freezing is -20. But either way, it's a nighttime in both parts of the world. Listen, I'm going to explain real quick here, Sov, how things are going to work tonight, so all our Habbos out there in Habbo land know what's the best way for them to get a chance to actually see you inside Habbo Hotel. Your character's running around in HabboHotel.com. Sov is about to jump into the Teen People Lounge on HabboHotel.com. She'll be flirting around there for about the first half hour or so. Then we'll be jumping north of the border to HabboHotel.ca, where she'll be linking up with me, Dileas, and Dubya, and we'll be running around inside the Canadian site. At the same time, as always when we do celebrity visits, we'll be asking questions posed by you, the Habbos, live here on the dnD Power Hour. Now, Sov, I gotta tell ya, these questions that have been chosen have come randomly from the Habbos. These are not something that me or W have put together. This is something that are actual questions submitted by real Habbos from right across the United States and right across the Dominion of Canada. And any question that gets asked on the air, we will be giving them a virtual turntable. This is an actual virtual turntable that the Habbos can use inside the game on your behalf. So thank you so much for that.
Actually, before we begin, I think Sov knows a little bit about Habbo.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Hey, Sov, why don't you give us a bit of history about your experience with Habbo Hotel? You were on it way back when it first started in the UK, right?
Yeah, when I was younger, when I was about 14, I paid it a little visit, and it's good. It's really good. It's It's good, but you know.
Let's dive into some questions here fresh from the Habbos. The first questions that we're going to be asking here, Sov, are coming from our American users down in HabboHotel.com. The first question is from Alex Anthony, and Alex Anthony wants to know, what is the best part about being a rapper?
The best part of being a rapper, you get to express yourself and say whatever you want to, and people enjoy it, and you know, you can just turn your expressions into music, and, you know, I enjoy it. I find it really fun. I love performing. I love going in the studio. I like some interviews. This one's cool.
Noted. Now, as far as the rap scene over in the UK, how does it compare to what you've witnessed already here on your travels to North America?
I mean, the whole UK scene is moving really slowly. You know, it's nice that I've got the appreciation over in the States and Canada, and, you know, hopefully I can fly the flag, but, I mean, in America and Canada, you know, it's such a big thing out there, and, you know, out here it's not as big as it should be, really, but, as I said, hopefully I can open a lot of doors and cupboards, and we'll see what happens.
I've got a question here for you from Beautiful Dove, and Beautiful Dove out of the U.S. wants to know, and this is kind of on the same vein as what we just talked about, what is it like coming to the USA from the UK, and is it a hard transition?
It's really weird, because to me, the States is like a different planet.
Oh, just you.
As well, don't worry. Go on.
You know, it's just so different over here, you know. It's a bigger place, there's a lot more people there, and... But, you know, I never thought in a million years that I'll ever be able to go out to, you know, the States. So now I've been there and seen it, it's a really cool place, and, you know, I want to see more of it. I've seen a small fraction of it, and it's all good so far.
What parts of the U.S. have you been to?
I've been to Boston, San Francisco, New York, where else? Oh, I can't think. yeah, I've been to a few places. Philadelphia, Chicago.
Wow, East Coast, West Coast, Central, the whole bit.
You were just in Chicago not too long ago, I think, right?
Yeah, I was in Chicago last week, just letting my hair down and visiting a few friends and stuff. It's a bit cold out there, though.
Yeah, well, it's called the Windy City for a reason. I got a question here for you from Mystic Maid, also from the U.S. Hotel, and Mystic Maid wants to know, what is the hardest, most challenging thing about being a female rapper in a world that is full of male rappers?
I mean, just the whole challenge of getting, you know, won over the guys, do you know what I mean? It's so male-dominated, you know, it's just a big challenge to be a female and to, you know, get out there and be successful. I mean, I'm not saying I'm successful yet, but I'm halfway there, I think. But just the whole, you know, being a female in a male-dominated thing, it's just, you know, it's fun. It's fun. Laughable.
We are live right now in HabboHotel.com. A Lady Sovereign has entered the Teen People Lounge. If you are in HabboHotel.com, go to the Teen People Lounge. She is running around in there. If you can't get into the room right away, just wait for a bit. The rooms will be cleared. You will get a chance to actually go in and talk live with Lady Sovereign. Just look for her with her VIP badge. We got one last question for you here before we play the next track, if you're ready, Sov.
Yep.
This is coming from MBall92, also on the U.S. site. And MBall92 wants to know, how does being a rapper affect your social life?
See, a lot of my friends ain't in the music game, so I kind of feel like the odd one out sometimes. But, you know, they're all proud of me, and they all push me to do my thing. But, I mean, sometimes it's a bit isolating, but I enjoy it. I think it's wicked. It's, you know, I couldn't wish for anything else. I'm happy. I'm really happy.
You get a lot of support from your friends, though, eh? I mean, you grew up in West London, right?
West London. North Wheezy.
Do you take any of your friends with you when you go on tour and stuff?
Not yet. Not yet. Soon, though.
I bet you they're looking forward to that day. We're going to be moving forward here on the dnD Power Hour here live and in full effect with Lady Sovereign broadcasting out of the UK, coming into HabboHotel.com. Shortly, she'll be in HabboHotel.ca. We're going to be spinning off here with another track. Dubya, what do we got on the plate?
We're going to put, the song's called A Little Bit of Shu, but it's a Small Stars remix by Ad Rock.
Sweet. Sov, we'll be back to you after this track. Subway, no bad to wait. So the only thing I'll be is have a way. Let me demonstrate if I keep the curry. Check out the bite, them that I create. And we're back live on the dnD Power Hour in full effect, fading off in the distance. A little bit of shh. We are here with Lady Sovereign, broadcasting out of the UK into HabboHotel.com. She is right now running around inside the Teen People Lounge. We got a whole bunch of people here hanging out. We got Maya, we got Fallout Girl, we got Seabass99, we got Godnetta, we got Mayer, we got Clay85, Afro and Green. Everyone's hanging out, having a good time. Lady Sovereign, hello in England. How are you?
Hello, how do you do?
Should we start playing Hail Britannia? I'm not sure. We got some more questions here from our colleagues south of the border. These are people coming to you from the land of Yankee, HabboHotel.com. And then afterwards, we're going to start with some questions in from HabboHotel.ca. But before we get into those questions, we just want to know here, because Dubya, I got to tell you this, Dubya has become a very much a closet fan of you, Lady Sovereign. I mean, when he first approached me and said that we were going to get you on the air, he was all excited and all giddy. And now even here in the studio, he is looking all giddy and all excited. So I just want you to know you've got a very big fan in Habbo. In the form of Dubya.
It's not closet at all. It's out there.
Now it's out there. Now it's out there broadcasting all through the Habbo land. We are very excited to have Lady Sovereign here on the air. We've got some questions for you here, Sov.
Huh?
This is from Hope76. Now, Hope76 has got a question that I guess has to do with choices. Hope76 wants to know, if you had to choose between your career and a serious relationship, what would you pick?
I would have a a career and then have a serious relationship at the same time.
The balance. Is there anyone special in your life right now?
Yeah. Kind of.
Kind of.
Sorry, W, your heart's broken now, buddy. Now, is this someone that travels with you whenever you come across the pond?
Just the management and my DJ and, you know.
Right, right. We got a question here from Kyle27M. Kyle27M wants to know, what kind of dressing do you like on your salad?
I don't eat salad.
Brilliant. Oh, there you go, Kyle27. Incidentally, just to remind everyone in Habbo Land, if your question is asked by Lady Sovereign and she answers it live on the air, you will be receiving a turntable in Habbo Hotel. That's on both HabboHotel.com and later on in HabboHotel.ca. Now, here's a question from Suzaki, which is obviously a play on Sulaki. Suzaki LP wants to know, where were you born? We know you're born in the UK, but where exactly were you born and where did you grow up?
I was born in London, North West London. I grew up in a place called Wembley, where the famous football pitch is.
Yeah.
Yep, that's where I grew up. I'm living in a bit of a posh area of London right now. I don't really like it, but I'm going to move again. But, London.
Sweet. I have to tell you, we are fans of London. The largest and one of the oldest Habbo hotels out there is, of course, the UK operations. We had a great visit going on there through the summer with Gorillaz coming in out of the UK, going all over the place. A lot of celebrities have come through, and we are really, really happy that now we've got you actually in the UK broadcasting to us. Thank you so much for taking the time to do this. We know how late it is over there, although you're a bit of a night owl, aren't you there?
Yeah, I'm a night owl. I can do the night. It's all good.
Sweet. We got some more questions for you here, Sav. Love Me wants to know, if you could pick only one thing to take on a desert island, what would it be?
I don't know. See, you can't really survive on much if you can only bring one thing to a desert island.
This is true.
Hard question. I don't know. Some music to entertain me, because, you know, as cliche as it sounds. But how am I going to play the music on a desert island? There's no electrics.
Well, I mean, I guess one of the things you could ask for would be a solar panel. I don't know. Music would be the key. We had Yellow Card on a couple weeks ago, and then, of course, all the guys immediately said their favorite squeeze. But, you know, what can you do with that? We got another question.
Actually, one of them wanted to bring a toothbrush. That was the one thing that he would bring.
Right. Yeah, toothbrush. Oral hygiene, buddy. Yeah. That's where it's at.
I'm going to see you if you're on a desert island anyway, so if your teeth go rotten, it doesn't really matter, does it?
That's true. I've seen Castaway, Tom Hanks. I know where it's at. We got a question here. Oh, this is a... Okay. This is a question from Skarotic. And Skarotic is asking a question that is... obviously, he's done a bit of background here because he knows what's big in the UK, but the terminology is a bit off. So I'm going to ask the question first using North American terminology, and then I'm going to convert it to you so it's the way it should be said in the UK. And Skarotic wants to know, what is your favorite soccer team? Which, of course, should be, what is your favorite football team?
Manchester United.
What? You go, buddy. Georgie Best all the way. Yeah, that's right. Sorry, we had a bit of a bet here. I knew it. M-Man-U. We won't go into that. But at Manchester United all the way. Good. Thank you. Sav, I just won some money. Well, Habbo credits. Okay, we got one last question here before we go to the next track. W is going to set up the next track here while I ask this. This is from Turn Left. And Turn Left wants to know, what is your favorite place to visit? Now... Why don't we add to that? What's your favorite place to visit when you're working, and what's your favorite place to visit when you're on holiday?
See, I kind of go wherever I get taken to. I mean, I don't really have favorites, really. I mean, you know, traveling the world is one thing I never expected. So, you know, everything and anything, really. I like getting out and about. You know. I don't know. I'm a bit of a couch potato sometimes.
Are you into the club scene at all over there in the UK?
Yeah, I go out sometimes, but I don't know. I prefer to invite my friends round to my place and, you know, just have a laugh, really.
Yeah. Have you ever been over to Canada? And if so, are you? If not, are you coming over at any time in the near future?
I've been to Canada. I've been to Toronto and I've been to Montreal. And it's really cold and really French and really different.
You like that? It's very cold and very French. Well, we have to get you over here in July when it's like plus 30, 35 degrees Celsius. Then you'll really get to experience the difference that is the Canadian weather. Listen, we got one more question here, and then we'll play the last track. But before we do that, quick shout out here going on from inside the Teen People Lounge here with Lady Sovereign running around on HabboHotel.com, Bammer, Wico, I Am Drive, Sweet 4 Raven, Ranger Scooter, Afro and Green, all running around inside the Teen People Lounge. Come on in, HabboHotel.com, look for Teen People Lounge on the public spaces. See if you can get in and hang out with Lady Sovereign running around inside HabboHotel.com. All right, here's the last question before we play the next track there, Sov. And this is from Finder Keeper. And Finder Keeper wants to know, what was your favorite song of all time?
My favorite song of all time. I can't single out one song. In all honesty, I love music and, you know, I listen to a lot of things. I don't have one favorite song. Sorry, I'm being boring right now, but I don't have one favorite song. But
What was your favorite song when you were like 13?
13. I don't know, man.
Back in school, or what? Something that you really listened to a lot?
Yeah.
Red Man, I'll Be That.
Oh, okay, cool, very cool.
What kind of music do you listen to? Like, obviously, you know, doing the whole hip hop rap thing. I mean, that's your mainstay right now. But is there a type of music that you listen to outside of that? Like when you're just chilling or driving in a car or hanging out at home?
I listen to everything, seriously. Yeah. I mean, you know, hip-hop, R&B, bit of electro, bit of indie, punk rock. Do like punk.
Sweet.
There's a whole, like, underground speed punk that movement that's coming back. Is that just me, or is this something that's really sort of starting to build momentum?
Oh, it's coming back. It's definitely coming back. And watch me have a go at it.
Oh, cool. Very cool. Looking forward to it, actually.
See? You know what? It started in the UK, and it's going to get resurrected in the UK. Right. There you go. I didn't have money on that one. I should have. You know, there would have been another bet. But anyway. Yeah. Listen, we're going to play the next track here, Sov. When we come back, we'll still be in HabboHotel.com. We'll hang out there for a couple more minutes inside the Teen People Lounge, and then we'll be making the jump north of the border, north of the 49th parallel, into HabboHotel.ca, and we'll start asking some questions to you from some of our users here in the Great White North. Of course, the only part of the North American continent that is still somewhat British. Well, not really, but we try. Yeah. Badly.
Yeah. All right. Here's a little Beastie Boys, and we'll be back after the track.
Ooh, the Beastie Boys. You gotta love that. We are back here on the dnD Power Hour, live and in full effect, broadcasting from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. We have just jumped. That is right. We are making the jump. Lady Sovereign was in HabboHotel.com. We are saying thank you and goodbye to America and getting ready to go to HabboHotel.ca.
That's right. And it's going to be a little bit different in HabboHotel.ca. Habbos who are in the hotel will notice that there is a random floor on the guest rooms section of the hotel. And so go ahead, stick your rooms on the random floor, and Lady Sovereign will be in your rooms.
Back in beautiful Canada. So, hey, you like maple syrup, Sov?
No.
That is so Canadian, eh? You make a snowball and then you actually dip it in maple syrup. Now, here's a question from Angry Bull. Angry Bull wants to know, what do you like more, cats or dogs?
I'm allergic to both.
Way to go, Angry Bull. What a question to ask. Are you seriously?
Cat, it was mine. I've lived with dogs too. I was going to get a dog a few weeks ago, but, you know, I'm a bit busy and it wouldn't have been fair. But I wanted to get a little puggle. I don't know. Cats are a little bit less, you know, hassle.
Right.
But, I don't know. Dogs and cats are cute. They're all good.
Well, we have a lot of Habbos out there that actually like their pets. Incidentally, in HabboHotel.com and HabboHotel.ca, actually any Habbo hotel you're in, you can go out and actually get pets that you can get, virtual cats and virtual dogs, and you'll remember that from your time on Habbo Hotel. Now, Sov, you were telling us a bit about your MySpace page. You got a page on MySpace, right?
Yep, myspace.com/LadySovereign. and I'm not going to spell sovereign. Maybe I should, because some people get the E and the I mixed up.
Yeah, go ahead.
S-O-V-E. Wait. Ah, it's confusing for me. S-O-V-E-R-E-I-G-N. Bit twisted.
If you go to HabboHotel.ca or HabboHotel.com, you can actually see a picture of Lady Sovereign on Habbo today and see the correct spelling of it, and go check out her page on MySpace.com/LadySovereign. Now, what are we going to find when we actually go to your MySpace page, Sov? What's listed there?
There's some, you know, exclusive tunes up there, songs for people to listen to. There's a US street team which you can sign up to if you want to help me out, please. there's a lot on there. There's, you know, it's me. I run it myself. No one else does it. It's not corporate. It's all me. I'm an internet nerd sometimes, so I'm on there quite a lot.
That is music to our ears in the land of Habbo. Incidentally, right now running around inside HabboHotel.ca, we are inside a makeway for the swoo room. Right now we got Riley, we got Jeep, we got Shaman 10, we got Honix, we got Details, we got Melon125, all hanging out with Lady Sovereign inside HabboHotel.ca, the sweetest smelling Habbo Hotel in the world. On that note, we got another question coming to you, Sov. This is from Trish Stratus. Trish Stratus wants to know, I really like your name. What made you choose it?
Don't know. Right, basically, it's a bit bad of me, but I had this friend. She was seeing this guy. He was being really horrible to her. They was trying to sort things out, and I was left sitting in this guy's house. And then I saw a sovereign ring, and I kind of took it, you know. And then I started collecting sovereign rings. It's a piece of jewelry that we have over here.
Okay.
Not saying she'd steal, but, you know, he was being horrible. But, yeah, I mean, we have sovereign rings out here. I don't think you lot have it over there.
No, can you describe it to us? Like, what exactly does it look like? What does it represent? Like, what is a sovereign ring?
It's a circular ring. It's gold, and it's got St. George slaying the dragon on it.
Okay, the one of the symbols of the UK, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
George's Day, and that's what it represents. But I just like sovereign rings, you know. I used to have one on each finger, but I lost them.
The rings are your fingers. We got a question here from Cop Cutie. Cop Cutie wants to know, what advice would you give to someone trying to get into the business? In other words, into the music business. What advice would you give to someone trying to get into the music business?
Okay, speaking on my experiences, be yourself. Don't try too hard. You know, if you keep at it long enough, someone will, you know, appreciate what you do and pick you up on the way and help you out. That's what happened to me. I didn't send a demo to anybody. I used the internet as my tool. It's a big place. It's easier to get your music across. I just used to, you know, post things up on forums and stuff and let people, you know, make their own mind up about it. And then it travelled about the internet, and that's how I got heard of. So, you know, use the internet as your tool.
How old were you when you first started posting your music on the net?
I was 14.
Wow. That's amazing. And it's, I mean, this is all stuff that you've self-written, self-created, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. I started out posting freestyles up, because I didn't know any producers back then, so I was just recording myself on a little PC microphone and sending it about to strangers, and you know, they liked it. Some people didn't, but you got to put up with the talk.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first freestyle that you posted?
Yeah, but let's not talk about it.
All right.
If you were 14, that would have been right around the time when you were just finishing up on Habbo, right?
Yeah.
Sweet. See?
I told
you, man. Good things come to good people. I got another question here for you. This is from Insulin. Now, Insulin wants to know, what type of genre of music do you really dislike? And don't... this is funny. Typically Habbo. Quote, and don't say nothing. There must be some kind of music you don't like.
Okay, I don't like opera. It's not up my street at all. Don't really like country and western. And I don't like, what is it called? hardcore metal.
Death metal. Right on. We're always joking here on the dnD Power Hour that at some point someone's going to have to take a bunch of ABBA tracks and turn them into really hardcore death metal and make a resurgence, but don't worry about it. That's something totally on the side. That's our next project, W. We got another question here. This is coming from Chris1491. Now, there might be some North American expressions in here, so if you don't understand any of the words that Chris here is using, just ask me, Sav, and we'll translate it into the Queen's English. Chris1491 wants to know, who or what inspired you to be who you are today, and what do you prefer, Cheese Whiz or peanut butter?
What the hell is Cheese Whiz?
Okay, Cheese Whiz is like it's like a cheese spread or a cheese paste. You know what Marmite is?
Marmite?
Yeah, you know what that is?
Yeah, I don't like it at all. I like the potato chips, the Marmite ones, but...
Well, think of Marmite, but instead of it being sort of like yeast-based, it's cheese.
I'll go with the peanut butter then.
Smart move. There's far too many chemicals in Cheese Whiz. Actually, can we say that on the air? Are we endorsing them? I don't know. That's the beauty of Habbo Hotel. We are broadcasting everywhere. We got a question here from Baby Stan, and Baby Stan wants to know, does it seriously always rain in the UK, or has everyone been lying to me?
It rained today, but sometimes we can have all four seasons in one day. It can rain, then the sun will come out, then it'll start snowing, then we'll have like a gale, wind, storm, you know. But in the summertime it's really nice, obviously, because we don't get a lot of sun, but It's all right. It's good to have the mixture. Do you know what I mean?
Now, you guys have had a really, really brutal winter this year, haven't you? I mean, we've been watching reports from the BBC saying that you guys have had snowstorms and, like, the highest record snowfall in decades and all that going on in the UK. Is that true?
Oh, that's only in Scotland.
Oh, okay. Up in the north, eh?
Yeah.
Right on. We're right now inside HabboHotel.ca with Lady Sovereign running around. Walmart is in here. Hottie would be 00 hanging out with Lady Sovereign. We got Nikkei. All inside the OA Guy Prezi room. This is a room owned by RC Dog, who's all hanging out. You've got well over a whole whack of Canadian Habbos hanging out here with Lady Sovereign inside Habbo Hotel. Let's see. Sov, we're going to play another track here, but before we go, is there anyone special that you wanted to do a shout out to over here in North America before we play the next track?
Oh, big up all the Canadians. Hello, how do you do, and all of that.
Sweet. Oh, someone from the mother country said hello to the colonies. Brilliant. Hey, when are you coming over next?
Huh?
When are you coming over next? When are you coming to visit us in the Great White North?
I'm not sure, but, you know, whenever I'm invited back, I'm going to race over there as quick as I can.
Well, if you ever end up on Much Music, let us know. We do all our marketing through them, and they're just around the corner here, so like not even three blocks away. So if you come over, you let us know, and we'll throw you back into the world at HabboHotel.ca. On that note, why don't we play another track here, W? What's next on the pipe?
This is a song that we actually call the Habbo song because it's called Cha-Ching, which is one of the only sound effects we have in Habbo Hotel. We'll be back right after the track.
Cha-Ching!
And that was Cha-Ching from Lady Sovereign's album Vertically Challenged here on the dnD Power Hour, live and in full effect, broadcasting from Toronto, Canada. We got Sav live on the air. Sav, how you doing, sister?
I'm all good.
You want to talk a bit about Vertically Challenged? How'd you come up with that name for the album?
I'm a bit of a midget. Well, not a real one.
Are you serious?
I'm the biggest midget in the game. That is me.
Okay. We've had circus midgets on the show at one point. So, like, how tall are you? What's your actual height? And we do use feet and inches over here too.
I'm 5'1" and a little bit, but I don't know how that works out in you lot's measurements.
Well, we use both in Canada because the U.S. is right next door, and they use imperial. We use imperial and metric, so we understand both. What you're saying is you're a pocket rocket.
Yeah, possibly.
Don't worry, it's a good thing.
Depends who's asking.
Yeah, good. Steady. This is a question here from one of our Canadian users there. Hoity Boy wants to know, Sav, what age group do you consider your music should be listened to by? In other words, what age group do you think your music is most appealed to? I can even answer that. It's ageless. I mean,
I mean, it varies. I mean, I've got teenagers listening. I've got people in their 20s, people in their 30s. Once I did this show and there was this man who must have been about 50-something right at the front. So, damn.
Was he into it or what?
He was moving. He was dancing and everything, man. He was getting his groove on.
As long as you didn't have to give him a pacemaker, it's all good. We're right now in HabboHotel.com. We are in Ryland's room, Make Your Way room. We've got Lady Sovereign hanging out here. We got Meeps. We got Louise Harmon. We got Goofer Devil. We got Hottie Would Be Bowed, Mafia, Kitty Lover, all hanging out here in HabboHotel.ca with Lady Sovereign, who is, of course, running around inside the rooms, having a good time inside HabboHotel.ca. Sov, I got a question for you here from a Habbo named Jessica. And Jessica wants to know, who inspired you to become a rapper instead of, for example, a country singer?
I think it's not Johnny Cash.
Yeah, yeah. Love's like a burning thing. Anyway. Sorry, go ahead, Sav.
Okay, it was Miss Dynamite. You know, before she, you know, got into the whole singing thing.
Sweet.
Yeah, she was on the underground. She was an MC, and she was the first female UK MC from the UK garage scene that I had heard of. So she kind of, you know, inspired me. But, I don't know, this is all self-motivated, you know what I mean? I love music, and I thought I'd try it out myself, and, you know, I've got my own style going on.
But, I mean, when you were growing up, did you, like, take music lessons? Did your parents get involved at all, or was it something that was entirely self-taught?
I kept it quiet. I didn't tell my parents or my family about it.
Really?
No, I didn't.
Oh, wow.
Until a good year afterwards, you know, and then I told them. Because, you know, most parents are kind of like, oh, it's music, you know.
So what do they think about you now? You know, big record contract, coming over to North America, doing your own thing. They must be super proud.
Yeah, they're really proud of me, you know, and it's nice. It's all good.
Well, I got a couple shout-outs here. These aren't questions, Sav. These are actual shout-outs from the Habbos, and they just want to say a couple things here. This is from Laura Liu, who wants to say, oh, my God, I have all your songs on my iPod. You are so awesome. How do you do it? We got another shout-out here from Tremblad, who wants to know, girl, you rock. You're proof that girls can rap. I'll be right close to the radio when you're on Habbo. Thanks for coming. That's from Tremblad. We got you got a lot of fans here in Habbo Hotel, and I mean, I think the Habbos are actually going to get a real kick out of the fact that once upon a time you were actually a Habbo yourself, and now she's back after a 5-year hiatus. We're hanging out here in HabboHotel.ca. We've moved to another room now. The Lady Sovereign's Hangout. This is owned by Dolly. Lady Sovereign's Hangout. Lady Sovereign is in there hanging out with Gino Player, with Stressed, with Underwears, with Meep63, with John Cressy Rocks, and a whole bunch of other people enjoying themselves inside HabboHotel.ca. Sov, we got some more questions for you here.
Go for it.
Okay, this is from Big Butt Sound, who wants to know, I would like to know, how does it feel going from, quote, a normal person to this growing rap star?
What's normal?
That's a good question. That's a good question. I think what he's trying to say is sort of someone that doesn't necessarily have the fame or the opportunity right off the bat that you're currently experiencing.
Okay, I mean, this whole experience is really overwhelming. You know, I didn't think I was going to do anything. I wanted to play football, soccer. That was my first love, but when the music came along, you know, it just took me away and carried me to this weird place. but, I mean, it's really overwhelming. You know, it's I don't know, I'm proud of myself and, you know, I ain't going nowhere.
Well, yet you should be proud. I mean, you've accomplished so much at the age that you are. Now, is there any times when you kind of sit back and you sort of wonder, you know, what is this really what I want to do, or is it unquestionable? This is totally what you want to do, and you're just going to carry on until you reach the top.
Oh, this is what I want to do. I believe in things happen for a reason, and yeah. You know, this has happened, and I'm not gonna, you know, throw the opportunity away. I love music. I love rapping. You know, I love entertaining people, you know, doing my whole stand-up comedy routine as well as performing when I do my shows.
Whoa, stop, back up. Stand-up comedy, really?
Oh, no, when I perform on stage, I mix it up a bit, you know. I tell jokes, I tell stories, I don't just perform my songs. I kind of entertain the people as well, you know.
Okay, this we got to see. You got to get your hubba butt over here to North America at some point in the next few weeks. We got to see this
next
time. Yeah, next few weeks. Well, next few months. Next time you're over here, we are coming to see your show, Lady Sovereign, because this is something we want to see. Comedy is where it's at. If you make the people happy, if you make them smile, they will follow you anywhere, and that's obviously something you've discovered. Here, we got one more question for you, Sov, before we go on to probably the second last track of the night. Yeah. This is from Devil Kitty. And now, Devil Kitty's got a bit of a serious question. And Devil Kitty wants to know, what has been the hardest trial throughout your musical career that you've had to face, and why?
Probably meeting Jay-Z. That was kind of nerve-wracking. I wouldn't say it was the hardest part of my career, but it kind of came out of the blue. So I was a little bit nervous, but, I mean, I don't know. I can't really think of anything that's really stepped in my way and tried to push me out of the way, really. I mean, haters, that's one bad thing, you know. But everyone's going to have a hater. You know, regardless of what you're doing, you're always going to have haters. But shake them off.
Yeah, people that are just jealous and want to take you down no matter how good you are.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, W, what's next in the pipe?
Actually, we're almost out of time, believe it or not.
Oh, really? Already?
Yeah, we've got time for one last song. So we can ask a couple more questions before we play the song, if you like.
Okay, yeah, let's do that. Sov, this has gone so fast. We're almost at the end of our time here on the dnD Power Hour. This is probably the fastest dnD Power Hour I remember. You're serious? We're out of time.
Yeah.
Look at that. We got 5 minutes left. All right, Sov, what we're going to do is we're going to ask you a couple more questions from the Habbos here in habbohotel.ca, and then we're going to say our thank yous and let you do some special shout-outs if you want to, and then we'll end off with the last track of the night.
Yeah, and just before, Habbos, don't forget, if you go into either the Citrus Club on habbohotel.ca or Functuary on .com, you can listen to Vertically Challenged, and it's kind of cool because you get to dance to the album itself, so it's a lot of fun. So go out and party in those rooms. And special shout-out goes to Seven from Chocolate Industries and Ricardo from InGroove for setting this up.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Definitely. And, of course, all the crew down in Santa Monica who have been supporting us at HabboHotel.com. Yeah. We got a question here, Sov, from Braden. And, Braden, this is a question you can actually answer legitimately. So, how does it feel being a little pixel friend on Habbo Hotel?
it's the same as what I am, really. I'm just a little pixel, if you like.
So it's like real life, yeah.
Okay, here's the last question for you of the night coming from the Habbos. And once again, as we were saying before, all the questions that we've asked tonight, they've actually been submitted by real Habbos, both in the United States and in Canada. And any one of the questions that were read aloud tonight on the dnD Power Hour, they'll be receiving, in your honor, a virtual turntable that they'll be able to set up inside their Habbo rooms. So here's the last question. Fatal T. Boo wants to know, hey, Lady Sovereign, if you had a time machine... what year would you go back to?
1977.
Okay, why?
I don't know. I wish I was there for the whole punk rock movement.
Oh, really? Yeah, see, that's the difference, eh? Because you grew up over in the UK, T77, it's like punk rock, whereas over here on this side...
Star Wars.
It's Star Wars. Yeah. Yeah, we think Star Wars. Way to go, W. That's because we're geeks. Really? No. You're getting into the punk scenes, like Sex Pistols and all that kind of stuff, eh?
I just love that whole movement.
Yeah, yeah. Well, as you were saying earlier, you're probably going to bring some of that back, eh?
Yeah.
Sweet.
No, it's amazing. We really love what you're doing. It's great sounds. Can't wait to hear more from you, actually.
Definitely, definitely. Now, this brings us to the close of yet another dnD Power Hour. Sov, on behalf of Dubya and myself and all the people here in HabboHotel.com and HabboHotel.ca, the Habbo users all over the world, and, of course, your fans and listeners that have come in and from your site into Habbo Hotel, thank you very much for coming on the show tonight. Thank you very much for running around with your character inside HabboHotel.com and HabboHotel.ca. You are welcome back anytime. It has been an absolute pleasure.
Oh, thank you for having me. It's been fun. It's been good.
And keep doing the music, definitely. We get a lot of celebrities on this show. We won't lie to you. We get tons of celebrities. And you are by far one of the most charming and easily one of the most talented we've had at such a young age. So we are very, very impressed. And I'm speaking for both me and W when I say that. So thank you again.
English. Hello.
Of course. Silly me. What's the last track for the night there, W?
We're going to put Fiddle with the Volume, which is another track off of Vertically Challenged. So thanks, everybody, for tuning in.
Thanks again, Lady Sovereign.
Thanks.
Okay, bonsoir.
Duckie World.
It's okie dokie. Right now, medicine and me.